Welcome back to Bay Sunday. From Good News in Oakland, we are now joined by Sean Kennedy. Sean, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Before we talk, we're going to take a look at a promotional clip from Good News in Oakland.
Hey. Oh, yeah, it feels great. Good news in Oakland.
Good news in Oakland.
Oakland's a big reason.
That's it right there. I'm good news.
It is not bad news or negative impressions that we stand by quietly while other people try to articulate who we are.
We have an incredible history already in Oakland that we get to build on.
I love Oakland.
It's been our home for 10 years now.
Oakland was on my back.
Good news is on the rise. It's Dr. Dre, and it's always good news in Oakland.
I love good news. Love good news.
So how did you get into doing that? What brought you here?
Well, actually, I'm born and raised in Oakland, and growing up in Oakland, I saw all the bad things that were happening versus all of the good. Mm-hmm. And I had an opportunity to get into the music industry, so I spent the last 15 years in the industry, and I opened a popular record store in Oakland, so I had a chance to interact with the youth. From that, I ended up working with Ron Dellums, mayoral task force team, mm-hmm. on looking at ways that we can explore art and entertainment in Oakland and create an economic engine from it. And from that, I ended up on the Cultural Affairs Commission, and looking at all the things that were happening in Oakland, I said, there's a lot of good news in Oakland and we need to exploit that.
Okay,
and so here I am.
So you want to exploit it.
Mm-hmm.
What has the reception been like when you call people? Because you had some really big names in that video.
Right.
When you come up to people and tell them your idea and what you want to do, what's the feedback that you get?
Well, most of the people that you see, the Gary Paytons and all those people from my entertainment business, I have relationships mm-hmm. within the entertainment field. Mm-hmm. So it's not hard for me to talk to an NBA player or somebody like Jay-Z and get them to do a promo or interview with me. Mm-hmm. Everybody's very excited about the good news that's happening, because it is renewable energy now. It's green. It gives you a sense of worth. It inspires you. People want to tell the good things that are happening in their lives. So we run into a Brian Shaw, you know, who's an Oakland resident and also assistant coach to Los Angeles Lakers. He has his house open for 35 young children from East Oakland who got scholarships.
Wow.
And he wants to spread the good news. He's very happy about being a participant. Gary Payton, Jason Kidd, all of those guys want to tell the good things that are happening in Oakland.
So, Ken, do you think that, I mean, because there is a stigma attached to mm-hmm. Oakland, and it's not just a local stigma, it is a national stigma.
Right.
How do you combat that? Is it just, you know, daily, you know, slowly but surely?
Well, the biggest fight that we probably have is in the old media way. Mm. You know, because you know you have the big stations that exploit the negativity that goes on in Oakland.
Mm-hmm.
But we have a new day now, and the new way now is through new media and social networking. And it's not hard to combat it now. When we post something good on Facebook or send a good tweet mm-hmm. out or put something up on our YouTube, people chime in with their stories, and they want to tell the things that are happening. We even had a person that called to let us know that their family still sits down to eat for dinner.
Oh, wow.
And that's good news, and
that
we want to let people know that that's happening in our community.
So I understand that people like you get it.
Mm-hmm.
Older adults get it.
Mm-hmm.
Do the younger kids get it?
Well, the younger kids do get it, and that's the reason why we incorporate entertainment.
Okay.
That's the reason why we incorporate sports figures and music figures. The perception is that the young people don't get it because the media created that perception.
Okay.
Okay, but like I said, now we live in new green technology, and we like to consider ourselves, like I said, renewable energy. We are here to, when you wake up in the morning, instead of hearing about the fire, instead of hearing about the car crash or someone who's smuggling a bomb through UPS,
yeah.
you get a chance to hear about Trinity Wilson, who's a young African American, 16 years old, that just placed sixth in the Singapore Olympics, Youth Olympics.
Oh, wow.
And is on her way to...
That's
to,
good news.
That's good news. Or you get a chance to hear about Aggie Stevenson, who just raised $20,600 for the 4-H Council, is on her way to Game 4 of the World Series that was sponsored by State Farm. So those are stories that are happening inside our community that we need to exploit and that we are exploiting. Or like the mayoral campaign is going down. Right now, we feature all of the mayoral candidates talking about what they're doing. And it's not that we endorse the candidates, it's that we're showing civic engagement. So people who don't get an opportunity to, you know, see what's going on in their community, we bring it to them via Good News in Oakland. And the good news is that we're civically engaged and there's a big election going on. We have 10 candidates. You get a chance to see what's happening.
Okay. So my last question, if people want to help you with funding or they want to contribute, you know, some good news, how do they get that information to you?
Well, you can go visit our site. It's www.goodnewsinoakland.com. Okay. The site won't be up until spring of 2011, but we have our Facebook up, we have our Twitter page up, and we have our YouTube up, so you can hit us any kind of way, or you can just email us at illtrendz@aol.com. That's illtrendz@aol.com. And just send us, you know, send us donations, send us good news stories, and let us know what's going on in your community.
Great. Thank you, Sean, for being here today.
Well, thank you for having
me. Now, that's good news.
That's good news in Oakland.
For more information, again, you can go to their website, www.goodnewsinoakland.com. And we're going to be right back.